late.
The Bio Center is working with Greenville Police to provide extra security surrounding the Dixie Chicks concert.
Here's all sit.
Bomb sniffing dog.
I mean, the Dixie Chicks are free to speak their mind. They can say what they want to say. And just because, I mean, they shouldn't have their feelings hurt just because some people don't want to buy their records when they speak out. I mean, freedom is a two-way street.
They shouldn't have their feelings hurt? What a dumb fuck. You're a dumb fuck.
And of course, everyone anxious to find out here what happens when the Dixie Chicks go before a live audience for the first time.
14,000 Dixie Chicks fans ready to go. Feels real good.
Greeted the Dixie Chicks as they opened their first U.S. tour since Maines made her controversial comment. The down-home greeting came just as President Bush addressed the nation aboard the USS Lincoln.
America is grateful for a job well done.
And you don't do it mass publicly.
Being ashamed of our president means being ashamed of our country. Move to France, Dixie Chicks.
Strong. Right.
City,
say it.
Tell y'all the American Red Cross wouldn't take $1 million from us.
Well, you do know that George W. Bush is the honorary chairman.
This whole week they didn't play us.
No one boycotted you.
Yes, that was a boycott.
That is not a boycott.
How is it not a boycott? They haven't been playing our music for a few weeks.
A boycott is when someone says, we are not playing.
Simon, actions speak louder than
words. What's the difference?
You tell me the difference.
No. All I know is all these radio stations, they pretend to support them, but they won't play them. We call and ask, and they won't.
No other artist that we play on the radio would get the kind of hate mail and complaint calls and I'm never listening to you again, I'm never doing business with you again. No one gets that. I could probably put Marilyn Manson on the radio station and not get that kind of negative feedback, even though we're a country station.
These people haven't, quote, boycotted us, but we haven't been playing our song and are partially responsible for our number one single to plummet.
I mean, I'm just trying to find some medium ground here.
Ignore it. It is up to them to do the right thing. We have not done anything wrong, and there's nothing for us to climb back from.
Yeah, that's shit.
How much?
Right now, you're down to 56 on the top 200, but yet...
Is that the lowest ever?
Yeah. I think Time's the greatest healer of all. Listen, they'll give Tracy Lawrence, who's a wife beater, another shot.
I don't want another shot.
until the mood of our audience changes, we're not going to play them anymore. It'd simply be financial suicide.
Keep playing, keep making music,
and keep your mouth shut.
Now that we've, you know, fucked ourselves anyway, I think we have a responsibility to continue to fuck ourselves. The rest of our career just better not be overanalyzed like this because of this one episode.
USA! 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 USA!
A series of hearings examining media ownership by returning to the topic that started it all, radio.
As a result of statements made by members of the Dixie Chicks at a concert, two radio networks, Cox and Cumulus, banned the Dixie Chicks from their playlists at a chain level.
Mr. Chairman, first of all, Mr. Renshaw refers to our radio companies as networks, and we are not networks. We are a confederation of 270 individual stations in 55 cities.
There's you made a decision from corporate headquarters that was binding on your DJs.
Mr. Chairman.
And just prior to that, you say that you're a group of independent radio stations. That's a total contradiction, Mr. Dickey.
I think that mischaracterizes it. As I mentioned, this was a collaborative decision-making process. Everybody fell in line. This was a unanimous, overwhelming decision.
Fell in line. I understand.
Do you think what you did sent any type of a chilling message to people that they ought to shut up
and not express their views one way or other?
I would hope not.
Okay, let me conclude on this. I think it does.
That was the envelope. You know.
Says Natalie Maines will be shot dead Sunday, July 6th in Dallas, Texas.